It's not the beginning of Skyfall, it's the beginning of the doubleheader. I'm Hari Sreenivasan with Mark Shields and David Brooks. I know the striking similarities to the new Bond.
I'm wearing the same suit as, yes. What's his name?
Yes, Shaken Not Stirred, that's what we are. So speaking of the election, Shaken Not Stirred, the SuperPacs and all this money that was spent on it, you know, Sunlight Foundation did, and I'll put a link to that, but a really fascinating effectiveness kind of measurement, a return on investment. And it found, for example, American Crossroads and the other one that Karl Rove runs had, you know, 1.2% or 14%, depending on which one. And then way down at the bottom of the list, you see...
Wait a minute, effectiveness?
Effective, like, you know, that actually, where they supported the candidates that won versus supporting the candidates, opposed the candidates that lost, right?
Wow.
And you scroll down and you see, for example, Planned Parenthood, there were a couple of super PACs there, and their effectiveness rate was 95-96%. They opposed every candidate that lost, and you know, it was. So do you think that in the grand scheme of things, this is going to make people think twice about pouring huge gobs of money into these elections?
My line is that they're spending too much on marketing and not enough on product development, and so they spend a lot of money on the advertising at the end of the campaign. They should spend a lot more on the ideas and the platform and maybe even recruiting candidates at the beginning of the campaign. And that would be money well spent, as opposed to the 9 millionth ad you're going to see in the first week of November.
So grow the candidate in a small laboratory.
Exactly, mm-hmm. Through machinery, Jurassic Park style.
Right, got it.
A controlled experiment.
A controlled AD.
No, uncontrolled. David's never been an advocate of uncontrolled experiments. I think money is noxious, pernicious, and damaging. And it goes beyond the commercials that you see. If you're a candidate, and one of these people is coming after you, one of these groups, you live in fear. Therefore, you become more timid, you become more cautious, you don't want to incur the wrath in case somebody else comes after you. And it's a terrible thing. There's no accountability. We don't know who the people are. We don't know specifically what their agenda is, other than to elect X and to defeat Y. And it's just a lousy, lousy, pernicious system, and the Supreme Court ought to be ashamed of itself for having pretended that unlimited money, anonymous money, poured into campaigns would not have anything other than a pernicious effect.
Okay. If I dropped a bunch of, this was a question that I got on Twitter as we did the late show after you guys were snug in bed, we were still here, and it says, if I dropped a bunch of matchsticks on the ground, would Mark Shields be able to tell me how many dropped? What is it about your mathematical skills? We have Nate Silver on one side, and you've got Mark Shields. I could say 43,648 minus 15,042, and somehow you would have the answer on election night. What is that? Where did you get that?
Well, I figured out early on that none of the others had any math skills at all. So I was just making up numbers, and oh boy.
That's that mark. He's supposed to be
good at math in school.
But it's just very simple. I mean, it's not difficult to do. I mean, if you're sitting there, you know, I mean, you just round it off to whatever the next zero is and add the difference. That's all.
It's really simple.
No, it's not that simple.
It doesn't work.
So when I see a big number like 56,000 and 42, it's like two clouds
me,
and I can't figure out how they relate to one another.
Gosh.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't see
and then
it that way.
Finally, in the
I had wonderful teachers in public schools.
All right, yeah. There you go. Nice
and
plug.
The politics. I grew up with a calculator, so with them.
I
never had a calculator.
Well, you know, on my Facebook page earlier this week, I said there's another touchstone is if you grew up in an era where Snuffleupagus was invisible to everyone but Big Bird, or not, because apparently in '85, everybody could see him. Beyond Big Bird, right? So then a bunch of people started, oh, yeah, I grew up before. Oh, I grew up after.
Oh, really?
It's one of those little, calculators versus abacus. So there's all right. Also, what was the name of that Lakers coach? It used to be the Lakers coach until, what, today, yesterday?
Mike Brown.
Mike Brown. Thank
Mike Brown,
you.
Gone?
Yeah, gone.
He's gone. He got fired.
One and four.
They're 1-4. They played five games.
I got to tell you, I mean, the Lakers are, I mean, the prima donnas of all sports. I used to think the Yankees were. But, I mean, I remember Magic Johnson fired the coach. You know, just didn't like the guy that used to be at Loyola Marymount that Paul Westhead had that loved the running game. You know, and it just, you know, what do you do? Who was it? Was it Kobe?
Kobe. Yeah.
I assume Kobe just said Mike Brown, you know.
Didn't like it.
I mean, had designed a play and the last time they had the ball that Kobe didn't. It wouldn't involve Kobe shooting. Yeah. He wasn't the first, second, and third option. I don't know. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, five games into the season?
What do you think? Premature?
I think so. But maybe there's backroom stuff we don't know. But, you know, give a guy a chance, five games.
Yeah.
I mean, it is, everyone has a chance to learn into the job.
Return of Phil Jackson, you think?
I don't think so. I think he's up on a mountaintop in Tibet somewhere.
Like meditating?
Meditating.
The future
of the
world.
Owner's daughter, wasn't it? I mean, that was never the end of that.
I don't know.
Jerry Buss's daughter and, really? Phil Jackson were the item.
Really?
Yeah. You want me to add it together?
Yeah.
One, three.
What's the average height there?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Well, at least you're not keeping up on the ins and outs of whether Justin Bieber is stepping out on... What's his, Selena Gomez, because of some Victoria's Secret model that he was spotted at the Lion King with yesterday.
Really? Were you at the Bieber concert he played here in D.C. this week?
No, no, that's all right.
He was at the Lion King?
See, that's what he's startled by.
Wow.
All right. Thank you very much. That is another exciting edition of the doubleheader. I'm Hari Sreenivasan, Mark Shields, David Brooks. Thank you very much.